In this video, we will take a look at using the AWS Data Migration Service to transfer data from our MySQL instance to an S3 bucket. And a common scenario here is you want to create some sort of data lake architecture. And by implementing this, you can take changes that might be in your application database, your transactional database that's in something like MySQL, and get it all over into S3, where you can combine it with other information and, you know, have it all stored in one location. So let's get started. In like everything else, you can find this from going to services and looking under migration and transfer in our case, and it's DMS. The first step here is to create an instance. So we'll give it a name. You can put a description, just, you know, demo, whatever you want. And we will give it the smallest amount of processing. And VPC, the virtual private cloud, and you can select the option that you have. And create. This is really the core processing behind it. This is what will allow it to run. And now what we need to do is create endpoints for the instance to recognize. So where does it start and where does it finish? Our source endpoint, in our case, it is an RDS DB, so it will recognize the one that we created, and it knows that it's MySQL, and give the admin. If this is unfamiliar to you, there is another video that shows how to create a MySQL instance using RDS. And run a test. This will make sure that it can connect. Successful here. Now let's create a new one, which will be the endpoint, meaning where do we want this information to land? In our case, S3. We'll put in an identifier. This will be an S3 type. And here's the role. So here's the server access role that we created in the most recent video, which was the policy and the role. Again, if this is not familiar to you, feel free to check out the other video on this. So what we'll do is hop over to the IAM dashboard and get the role that we created. Now, if you recall, if you did watch, I accidentally named it policy, but it is a role. Copy that ARN and paste it here. So now this service will inherit all of the permissions that we created on that last video, which if you recall were the ability to full permissions on S3, so it can read and it can write on S3, which it will need here. And it also has the permission to operate as part of this data migration service. Now, what bucket do we want to put this in? We'll use the one that we created in a previous video, which is this test bucket. Grab that name and put it in here. You can put a folder, a specific folder, if you want. We won't right now. And let's just test this out. So, all right, so successful. Let's create it. So now we have our two endpoints. We have the DB, the MySQL database, and we have the S3 bucket where we want that information to land. The next step is to create a task, meaning what do we want? We now have an instance running this. We have a source and an endpoint, but what do we want it to do? Give it a name. I will say this is what we're going to copy it, so I'll just call it copy DB to S3, the instance. Select our sources and targets that we've created. And the different types here, I think, are pretty self-explanatory. And what we'll want to do is not only migrate everything that exists today, but also continue to replicate it. And we'll actually have to make another change for that to work. And specifically, that means being able to recognize every single event that happens. So when you insert a new record, delete something, it needs to be monitoring and replicating that as well. So let's select that one. And here's that note saying, hey, if you want to do this, you need to have your logs set to row level changes. So let's hop back into our RDS, because that's where we can change that setting. Let's select parameter groups. I'm going to create a new one that has this setting enabled. You could adjust one that exists already, but I think a more appropriate thing to do would be to create a new one that is, you know, exactly what you want. Now let's go in here and search. First click edit parameters and let's find the one we want. In this case, it's bin log and it's bin log format. The default is mixed, but if you recall, it said it must be set to row for those ongoing changes to be captured, and save it. If we double check, we can see it's there. Okay, so we've satisfied that requirement. There are a bunch of other settings here as well. We're going to leave these on as the default. And now down here, we can actually pinpoint exactly what we want this service to look for in our RDS instance. So, you know, is there a particular schema or tables that we only want to focus on? That's where you could modify this here. As an example, let's connect to our MySQL instance to prove how this works. Let's create a new database. Call this TestDB. And within it, let's create a table. Also called test table. And what we'll do then is say, hey, we only want this migration service to look where it falls within this test DB. We don't want any other databases or schemas to be recognized. Let's add some values to this table. We'll update this to say, only look where the schema, which in the case of what we just did is really the equivalent to a database as it was designed, TestDB, only look from there. Let's create that task. Now this is running. We can see it's full load, ongoing replication. So we would expect those initial values to be put in to the S3 bucket. They should have been captured. So this actually failed, and I think I know why. So let's take a look. The logs must be set to row. Now we did do that. We did create that group and we said, look at row format. But what happened was we actually didn't apply that group to the MySQL server. So that parameter group with that setting exists, but it's not being used. So let's go back to the DB instance and make that change. If we go to configuration, the parameter group is still on that default, meaning we need to use that demo one that we created. So this actually proves that you do need to have that row setting for this to work. Now let's modify and flip that. Let's find the parameter group. There it is. Let's use demo group. Now this should have that row level logs enabled. Continue. And we're going to have to apply this immediately for the sake of time. So modify, click apply immediately and modify DB instance. This might take a few, so I'll pause this and we'll wait. Okay, so now if we refresh, we see this is pending a reboot, so we actually need to reboot the server for this to take effect. So I'll go ahead and do this, pause the video while we wait. Now it's ready. This parameter group is in sync, and let's try this again. Restart. And now it's going to try again to first copy everything, and then second, once it's successfully copied, it'll continue to monitor those logs. Okay, so now this is running. And after some time, we can say load complete and replication ongoing. Let's check our S3 bucket to confirm that those files made it over there. And here it is, TestDB, right down to the table, and it drops it in as a CSV. Let's take a look at this. We have those two records. So pretty neat. It recognized those records that were in our MySQL database, copy them over to S3. Now let's see what happens when we add some more information. Let's add some new records or delete something and see what kind of, you know, what that looks like, how quickly it captures it. And let's see what that looks like. So I'll just go in here and add a new one. I'm doing this very, now this is a very simple example, but you can imagine if you have, you know, some sort of live application and you're constantly adding data, this is pretty valuable to be able to put it all into one place that can act sort of like a data lake. And now pretty quickly, you can see that here's the next one. And that was only a few seconds. Steve, there it is. And you see that indicator of I for insert. So that's helpful for maybe future ETL processes that you can pick out what was an insert, what's a delete. Let's delete one here. Delete John. Sorry, John. And go back. Refresh. Not yet. We can take a look at the statistics. So it did recognize it. It picked it up. So maybe we just need to go try again. Refresh. So okay, this is a little bit of, there it is. A little bit of a lag, but still pretty solid. Let's take a look. This one should be the delete. There you go. See a D for delete and the record. So within just a few seconds, really, you know, that information is being replicated over, and we can monitor it. I hope you found this helpful, and thanks for watching.